I will keep it virtual to this press conference because I would like to announce something very welcome. First of all, ladies and gentlemen, we are very proud to present you our new product here for Prague, which will be the CEPA EXPO for 2011. We will hold this exhibition for business aviation aircraft in Borgoli Airport. It is an exhibition for business aviation, for business leaders, manufacturers, corporate aviation departments, and all other people in all aspects of aviation. This is very important for us as we do this in Central Europe. It will be held on a yearly basis, and we will put Prague in the spotlight of Central Europe for such a big event. CEPA EXPO, as I said, will be held in Borgoli Airport, and it will be on the 29th of September for 3 days till 1st of October. There will be a static display for more than 50 aircrafts, and worldwide manufacturer and operator will have the opportunity to present their product on this CEPA EXPO. We personally thought that the period in autumn is a good opportunity for future owners to decide when they are closer to the end of the fiscal year ending and about the new investments. We expect some turnover of, first of all, we expect some between 3,000 or 4,000visitors on the first exhibition 2011. We expect a turnover of €500,000, and we definitely expect something between 120 and 150 international exhibitors on the business edition. I think this is a very important event for Prague itself. It has a big impact on the hotels, on the suppliers, on everything that the whole expo, as we think, will grow in the next 5 years. And we will, as I said, also put Prague in the spotlight of first of all, Central Europe, and secondly, it will have a big impact on the city as well.
We are really quite interested in this model of the Central European market is growing fairly rapidly, and we see private aviation becoming more and more important as a means of doing business. One of the big problems is the limitations of scheduled airlines. They fly mainly to the major cities, but quite often for businessmen there's a requirement to go some distance from the regular hubs. And we definitely see private aviation becoming more and more important in this part of the world.
Those who are in this meeting, journalists, I just would like to have you ask you if you can say just the name of the media and then of course the questions. Thank you.
That's Bill Sire from Blue Sky Media. I have a question. What is your position and your relationship going to be to eBay and eBay?
Well, I can definitely answer that we will be competitors. And we think that eBay is very important as an expo and as a convention. But we think that that it's very important to do something on the Central European market, and also for us the most important decision to do it was the time. In autumn it is absolutely crucial to go for it. We think it's much more
important. I can do it without my microphone. What kind of facilities are you going to use at the Borgoli Airport, for instance? Do you have tents or what?
Yeah, we'll use well, we've got a variety of options, but probably we'll put up a couple of large marquees. We might be able to access some buildings as well. There are a few logistics issues, but they seem very confident there, being able to provide what we need. They've certainly got a good distance runway. They've got parking areas. They've got access to the public. They've thought this through. Very good access road which links from the side road, and there's another road out, so there's a proper through flow. We've talked to them about marshalling, and all of that seems to have been thought through, so we're pretty confident. It's a good facility for sure. It's comparable in terms of layout with other airports that we're familiar with. So it will work well, certainly throughput won't be a problem. And setup in terms of tents and the stallions, this is a good area for static display as well.
I would like just to add a small comment. We would like to make it a little bit different than the current expos. We'd like to have we would like to have it divided into specific areas. That means that we consider that all the operators should be in one area and all the brokers. I mean, this is a very special expo. Yeah? It's business aviation, so it's for special people interested or meeting in this field. So it's more easy for the clients to choose. Basically, on top of all, we would say that we would like to improve everything what doesn't run so well on our competitive expos. That's also the main message for me.
My name is Susanna Arnaxon, and I'm owner of the international magazine My Central and Eastern Europe. And my question is, I'd like to know if the expositors of the travel from the center of Eastern Europe, or if that would be like that would be from all around the world, like Europe, or which kind of expositor would you focus on, like more important?
Yes, I think that this expo should not only cover Central Europe, but of course it should open the gates to Central Europe. It should allow the people from Central Europe to focus on this expo as such. Currently, at eBay's in Geneva, there are not that many exhibitors from Central Europe. We would like to encourage all our colleagues to come as a visitor or as exhibitor. Personally, I think that the European market in general is focusing on worldwide. Of course, there will be some visitors coming worldwide, but in business aviation, there are just two markets. One is the American market and one is the European market so far. So we would like to reach the European market and we would like to reach the Central European market.
I would like to ask you, what's the main attraction, according to you, for the exhibitors to connect with you and not with the base?
As I said at the beginning, that we think that the time we do it in autumn is much better for most of the investors and most of the people interested in this innovation. And secondly, it's the connection to the Central European market. I personally think this is very important because we, with the CEPA EXPO, we cover the whole European market, I think.
Yeah, hi, John Brennan from World Aircraft Sales Magazine. Just following on from the question about the formation of CEPA, particularly to you, Dagmar, was it your feeling that EBAA were not providing the sort of support and connections that you felt was needed for Central and Eastern Europe? And was that the driving force behind you deciding to launch this organization?
The Central European market is a very new market, and it has a completely different language, issues, access, bureaucracy, and definitely a cultural aspect. And for me personally, as I have been growing up in a Western Europe country, and I live here since 16, which I highly appreciate, it's my home here. I found out that it requires a lot of experience to deal in the Central European market. And I personally think that EBAA tries, of course, to do this, to cover this area, but I personally think that it's not done in the way it could be done and in the way we do it now due to our year-long experience. And that's the reason for that.
Yeah.